Good morning again. Delighted to introduce now for our next ministerial keynote interview, Mihály Varga, who is the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Finance for Hungary. Mihály, welcome. Thank you for joining us.
Welcome from Budapest. Thank you.
Thank you. My first question is about the deficit. What has happened to the deficit as a result of COVID and mitigation efforts for COVID? You began the year with an estimate of very healthy 1% deficit, and people are now talking about 7 to 9% possibly. Now, lots of other countries, of course, are in the same position. But have you adjusted your funding plans in response to that?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would like to thank you for the opportunity to share our experiences and further plans in our combat against the pandemic. Despite the fact that the top priority of Hungarian fiscal policy in recent years has been the ensuring the fiscal discipline, we also needed to adjust our deficit forecast. We expect the 2020 deficit to be around the level you referred to, which is in line with the estimated EU average. To finance the deficit, we rely on both domestic and international sources, while we have successfully increased the duration of our debt portfolio. We have issued considerably more Hungarian foreign-denominated bonds than previously expected. Beyond the institutional sector, households were eager to purchase these papers. To ensure the stability of debt management and to take advantage of preferential global market conditions, Hungary has also tapped international markets via FX bond issuance, among others, with green bonds. Our issuance in 2020 were outstandingly successful with adequate timing, high demand, and low yields. The share of FX debt in overall government debt remained under 20% within the 10-20% target band. And last but not least, the fiscal policy has been complemented on the monetary policy side by a quantitative easing policy carried out by the central bank, the National Bank of Hungary, to ensure sufficient liquidity for the banking sector.
Well, that brings straight on to the second question, and it's a very interesting point to look at worldwide and certainly in the region, where you've seen central banks in the region doing more in terms of QE, and this sort of blurring between monetary and fiscal policy. But just to look at the fiscal side, Hungary's response has been rather smaller than that of some other countries in terms of percentage of GDP. Now, is that because of a lack? Has that been because of a lack of relative need, or is it because you feel that other methods, monetary stimulus, for example, are more effective in facing this crisis?
Our response to the pandemic, both budgetary and non-budgetary, amount around 30% of the GDP. So I believe it's not a clear or a small portion of the GDP. With this figure, Hungary has the second biggest COVID-related assistance package in the European Union. The Hungarian crisis management is based on the combination of the fiscal and monetary policy. On the fiscal side, our primary goal is the protection of jobs. The current COVID crisis hit when our employment figures were remarkably high, much higher than before the 2008-2009 crisis. I have to mention that the unemployment figure was just 3.4% before the pandemic. So it's a relatively low level of the unemployment, and we were among the best four countries in the European Union. Therefore, we were in a relatively favorable position. However, the structural effects of the current crisis are much more remarkable. A drop in economic performance of contact-intensive sectors like tourism has been measured by the increasing performance in the health industry and digital platforms. Therefore, the Hungarian strategy focuses on employment rather than jobs themselves. The government reacted early by temporary tax cuts for companies in distressed sectors and by introducing a loan moratorium for both households and firms. We also introduced compensations, loan subsidies, investment programs, and further traditional measures. Beyond these, active labor market policies have been scaled up for reskilling and upskilling. Given the fact that Hungary is a small open economy, typical demand enhancing measures didn't play a key part in the policy mix. As a result of the successful policy actions, the crisis didn't hit employment too much. In fact, the latest figures suggest that by mid-summer, primary labor market employment would grow compared to the same period of the previous year. I also have to mention that the latest figures of the statistics office in Hungary shows that the unemployment rate was just 4.1% in November, so it's relatively low level of this this question. The success of our crisis management has also been acknowledged by international markets. I already referred to our successful international bond issuance, but let me also highlight that Moody's improved the outlook of Hungary's current credit rating from stable to positive. So this was a really rare accomplishment in Europe in 2020.
The response obviously has been huge. I would just mention that the balance is somewhat different between the fiscal and the monetary side. I remember talking to your colleague Gabor Guillon a year ago at this conference about the employment question. And of course, the problem then was a lack of workers, the super employment. So it's very good to know that that employment pressure has continued and the employment unemployment is very low, as you've just stated. Now, very quickly, talking about employment and about industry, something I wanted to turn to as we close is the whole question of supply chains. Hungary obviously has benefited from the integration of supply chains, especially with Germany and in the auto sector. There are some threats to that now, but equally there are lots of opportunities as people diversify supply chains away from China, for example. Do you expect Hungary to pick up some benefit of that?
There are two sides of this question. The first, regarding the possible future of the Hungarian economy. You are right, as about 90% of the Hungarian automotive production is exported, the performance of external markets is a critical factor for the car manufacturers settled in Hungary. Germany is Hungary's most important trading partner and biggest investor. I am glad to say that according to the latest research by the German-Hungarian Chamber of Industry and Commerce, the majority of German companies find their business situation in Hungary satisfactory, and many of them plan to increase their investment this year. Regarding the future of automotive industry in Hungary, it is important to highlight that the ability of Hungary to attract investment is supported by the low corporate income tax rate, the favorable business environment, competitive wages, skilled workforce, and good infrastructure. On the other side, the budgetary package of the European Union, because in this year we will open the possible programs for the small and medium-sized entrepreneurs and the whole economic sector to use these sources from the European Union. Thanks to the consensus reached on the EU budgetary package, all countries can now start to benefit from the substantial financial support to further combat the crisis. Regarding the newly adopted budgetary conditionality, it has to be highlighted that its objective is protection of the EU budget against fraud, corruption, and conflict of interest. Hungary fully supports this objective. However, in our opinion, the compatibility of specific regulation on budgetary conditionality with the EU law is still questionable on many accounts. Therefore, Hungary and Poland have decided to initiate a procedure at the European Court of Justice in Luxembourg.
Yes, of course, listen, those developments are being watched very closely. Minister Varga, I'm sorry we've run out of time. Fascinating to catch up with you, albeit so briefly. Thank you very, very much indeed for joining us and answering some of these questions and for putting the case for the Hungary's recovery out of this crisis that really nobody expected. Thank you very much indeed again, Minister.